Hello guys, this is Muskan Lalwani from Autonomous PG College. Today I aim to explain the characteristics curve of the vacuum tetrode valve. To explain the characteristic curve of the vacuum tetrode valve, we'll first discuss the introduction, then construction and then working. Firstly, we'll explain the introduction. A tube contains 4 electrodes, a cathode, an anode, control grid and a screen grid enclosed in a high evacuated glass envelope. It's called the vacuum tetrode. In comparison to the tetrode valve, another grid is between plate and a control grid called the screen grid is introduced. In tetrode valve, this screen grid reduces plate to the grid capacitance. Now we will see the construction of the tetrode valve. In the triode valve, we see there is no screen grid. But in the tetrode valve, we introduce the screen grid between the control grid and the anode. We can see there are the 4 electrodes. Firstly, cathode, then control grid, then screen grid, and then anode. The cathode is being heated indirectly by the filament. As the cathode is heated, it starts emitting electrons. As the electrons are emitting, it passes through the control grid G1. The number of the electron emitted and passing through the control grid G1 is controlled by applying the negative potential through the control grid G1. The electron passes through the control grid, it reaches through the screen grid G2. If and only if the screen grid G2 is comparatively at the positive potential as compared to the control grid G1. Finally, as the electron reaches through the anode, then the current starts flowing in the external circuit. Now we can see that as the number of electrons are emitting from the cathode, it is in our direct control by the control grid that how much amount of the electron is reaches to the anode. We can control the negative potentials of the control grid and we as many amount of the electron we want, we will get in the anode. Now we will understand the working of the vacuum tetrode valve. The grid G2, the function of the screen grid is to control the number of the passing electron through it and reduce the capacitance between the plate and the G1. The screen grid acts as a series combinations of the two capacitors C1 and C2, which is connected in between the plate and the screen grid, and the another capacitor is connected between the G2 and the G1. So the reduced capacitance, that is the minimized capacitance, is equals to C1 multiplied by C2 divided by C1 plus C2. The capacitor between the plate and the grid of the tetrode valve generally lies between the 2 to 10 pF. But in the tetrode valve, it reduced to only 0.01 pF and it helps to flow the electrons smoothly and provide the path for them. If we provide the small negative potential to the G1 and with respect to the cathode and provide the large positive potential to the plate, that is approx 300 volt, and positive potential is provided to the G2. The capacitance reduced to the flow of the electron be maintained because screen grid current reduced to the plate current. Screen grid prevent the electron moving from the cathode to the plate and become the feedback. Control grid G1 control the number of the upcoming electron from the cathode K. Now we will get familiar with our apparatus of the tetrode valve. Here in this apparatus we are provided with the 2 voltmeter. First is to measure the bias voltage and second is for the measuring the anode voltage, and secondly we are provided with the milliammeter which will calculate or the measure the anode current, and then we are provided with the meter which will calculate the screen current and the screen voltage. We can change the bias voltage by the changing the bias voltage controlling knob. If we change in it the clockwise direction, we'll change the bias voltage. Similarly, we are here provided with the anode voltage controlling knob. If we change in it the clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction, we'll get the change in the anode voltage. If we want to measure this bias voltage in a positive, then we'll turn this toggle switch in the positive. And if we want to measure it in the negative, then we'll divide this toggle in the negative. This meter which is provided here for measuring the screen current and the screen voltage. If we turn this toggle switch towards the milliammeter, then it will measure the current. And if we turn this toggle switch towards the volt, then it will measure the voltage. Firstly, we'll turn on our apparatus and keep all the knobs to the extremely left positions. and the voltage regulator knob will set the bias voltage towards the 0 volt. Now we'll divert this toggle switch towards the volt, and now we will set the screen voltage to the 100 volt. This is done by the providing knob below it. Since we have to measure the screen current, so we will divert this toggle switch towards the milliampere side. Now we have to set the anode voltage to the 0 volt. This can be done by the knob which is provided below it. Now as you see, anode voltage as we kept in the 0 volt, then we will measure the anode current, that is 0 milliampere, that is IP. And as we measure the screen current, that is IS, it is a 10 milliampere. Now we'll set the anode voltage at the 5 volt. And now we'll measure the anode current, that is IP, and screen current, that is IS. Similarly, we increase the anode voltage, that is VP, to the 10 volt. And now we'll calculate the anode current and screen current. Set to the voltage to the 25 volt. As we set the voltage VP to the 25 volt, we'll measure the anode current, and similarly we'll measure the screen current. Now we'll set the anode voltage to 50 volt, and we'll take reading of anode current and screen current. Now in the interval of 25 volt, we will read the reading of the anode current and screen current. Up to 300 volt VP, we'll record the reading of IP and IS. We will set VG to the minus 2 volt and the anode voltage to the 5 volt. And we'll record the reading of anode current and screen current. Then we'll set the anode voltage to the 10 volt and we'll measure the reading of IP and IS. Similarly, we'll set it to the 25 volt and record the reading of IP and IS. Similarly, in the interval of 25 volt, we'll record the reading of IP and IS. Up to the 300 volt, we'll record the reading of IP and IS. Now we will set the VG to minus 4 volt and we will record the reading of anode voltage, anode current and screen current as we have previously done. Now we will set the voltage towards the positive side, and it is positive 2 volt, and we will record the reading of anode voltage, anode current and screen current similarly as we have previously done. Now we will set VG to 4 volt and we will record the reading of anode voltage, anode current and screen current similarly as we have previously done. For VG equals to 0 volt, as we have said VP equals to 0 volt, then we will measure IP equals to 0 milliampere and IS equals to 10 milliampere. For VP equals to the 5 volt, we'll record IP equals to 2.5 milliampere and IS equals to the 11 milliampere. For VP equals to the 10 volt, we will record IP equals to 7.5 milliampere and IS equals to 7.5 milliampere. Similarly, in the interval of 25 up to the 300, we will record the reading of IP and IS. For the VG equals to minus 2 volt, we will show the reading of IP, IS. This column show the reading for IP and IS for VG equals to minus 2. And similarly, this column VG equals to minus 4 will show the reading of IP and IS. For VG equals to plus 2 volt, we'll show the reading of IP and IS. Similarly, this column VG equals to plus 4 volt will show the reading of IP and IS. Here, we will see the characteristic curve of the tetrode volt. We have taken the anode voltage at the x-axis and anode current at the y-axis. The pink curve shows the characteristic curve of the tetrode volt at VG equals to plus 4 volt. Similarly, the green curve shows the characteristic curve of the tetrode volt at VG equals to plus 2 volt. Brown curve shows the characteristic curve of the tetrode volt at VG equals to 0 volt. Similarly, the light green curve shows the characteristic curve of the tetrode volt at VG equals to minus 2 volt. And the orange curve show the characteristic curve of the tetrode wall at Vg equals to minus 4 volt. These curves are quite similar to the characteristics curve of the tetrode wall theoretically. Hence, we conclude that our practical is correct. I hope you understand this experiment. If this video is helpful to you, please like, share and subscribe to our channel.